What's going on, guys? Welcome to the video. We got a quick one here, but it's something I had to cover, as it's relating to the Brexit celebrations planned for the end of the month that I'm hoping to attend. This is relating to a talk radio show segment where a salty Ramona was complaining about the Brexit Day celebrations and claiming there will be pro-EU protests of much greater numbers than the Brexiteers, which I have to say, I'm highly sceptical of being true. We all know the media have always hyped up the pro-Remain protests and their numbers by a fair amount, including claiming there was 1 million or even a couple of million people at one of them, I believe. It's absolute nonsense, as we all know. But The Express did an article on it saying little spoilt children. Outrage as Remainers vow to disrupt Brexit Day celebrations. Remainers have vowed to out-protest Brexiteers as the UK gears up to mark its official exit from the European Union at the end of the month. Well, they won't out-protest Brexiteers because Brexiteers are not there protesting. They will be there celebrating. So that subheading there is completely wrong. But they can vow to do what they want. I don't think it's going to succeed. Remain activists have refused to stay silent with just 2 weeks to go until Britain officially leaves the EU. A prominent Remainer has revealed there will be a pro-EU rally near Parliament Square if Brexiteers try to hold celebrations there. This comes as Brexit supporters mull over how to celebrate Britain's long-awaited departure from the bloc. Oh no, we know how to celebrate it with a massive party. There will probably be a few of them round the country. Maybe not officially organised like the one in London, but hopefully local councils or Brexiteers do manage to put something on for people. After the shit show that we've gone through for the last 3 years, I think we all deserve one, don't you? Pro-Brexit politicians like Nigel Farage are promoting a party in Parliament Square to mark the occasion, which is the one I am hoping to attend. The government is also set to encourage councils and community groups to fly the Union flag to celebrate Brexit. I will personally be flying a couple myself. Jonathan Liz, Deputy Director of the think tank British Influence, responded to plans for a Brexit celebration in Parliament Square on January 31st. He told Talk Radio, and instead of me reading it, let's actually listen to what he had to say for himself.
Do you think there should be a party?
Well, I think people want to hold their own parties to celebrate leaving the
European Union. But we're talking about an official celebration in Parliament Square.
Something in Parliament Square.
Yeah.
I think, I agree that the bells tolling out across the country is a bit of a mad suggestion. And as Jonathan says, I think Leavers should be gracious in victory. And I don't think that sort of celebration should be forced upon Remainers. Whether there's a party in Parliament Square, I mean, I don't think that would be particularly in poor taste. I think that's, you know, that democracy.
I mean, here's some, sorry to interrupt, but here's something, you know, looking at what's coming in. And I'm personally, where I stand is, yeah, go ahead, knock yourselves out. If you want to have a party, have a party.
Yeah. Okay, we're going to have a counter demo to match it, and we'll have bigger numbers.
I couldn't really care less if you want to have a party. I know for some people it'll be a significant day. If some people have waited 40 years for this day.
Right, so at least two of the people in that clip seem like Remainers to me, including the shit weasel you see in the picture there. But one of them's ready to accept that Brexit's going to happen and people are entitled to celebrate it if they want. The shit weasel in the green t-shirt, though, not a chance. He thinks there's going to be counter-protests with more Remainers there than Brexiteers. Which, to be honest, won't really matter. They can counter-protest there all they want. We'll still be celebrating, and we'll still be leaving the EU. Because guess what, fuckpig? You lost. Get over it. But it really does go to show something I've said many times. We are going to be salt mining these pricks for years to come. Maybe even decades. Who actually knows? They spend too much time eating their avocado on toast and drinking their soy lattes to ever understand what is going on in the real world. Which is why, even after losing multiple times, they still seem to think the country wants to remain in the EU. And this wanker Steve Bray is probably one of his good friends there. Miss Liz later tweeted, "A national party on the 31st of January, millions of us will be heartbroken." Well, I'm sorry to say, sweet cheeks, that is life. Things don't always go your way. Our EU citizenship is being taken from us. Our membership of a dynamic community shattered for no reason. No, there is a reason. The people of this country voted to leave the European Union multiple times over the last 3 years. So, that is the reason. And as for your EU citizenship being taken, no, it's not. The Hosh Twat has offered all of you Ramonin fuck pigs EU citizenship if you actually want it. So you can stop crying your bullshit on Twitter, because aside from your echo chamber, the rest of the country ain't buying it or just doesn't care. Most of them probably just don't care. We'll never support Brexit, we'll never like it, and we certainly won't celebrate it. Well, that's a good thing. You don't need to support it, you don't need to like it, and no one wants you there celebrating it. So you can take a running jump for all anyone actually cares. The stubborn Remainer was greeted with fury from Brexiteers, even as the talk radio host Alexis Comran said people have waited 40 years for this day, which of course they have, and now they should actually finally get it. One viewer tweeted in response, "Why are these Remainers like spoilt little kids who didn't get their way?" Well, that's exactly what they are. As for the reasons why that is, the jury is still out. Another similarly added, "Simply unable to be gracious in defeat like a child. If I can't have it my way, then I'm going to spoil it for everybody." Nah, he won't spoil nothing. You just ignore him at the end of the day. That is the best way to stop them. If you don't pay them no attention and you just keep celebrating, then they realise that they've lost. And they can just go and cry on Twitter again. MPs debated last week on whether the country should mark the incredible occasion. Conservative MP Marc Francois urged Big Ben to bong for Brexit at 2300 hours on the 31st of January or midnight in Brussels. But they have decided that it's too expensive and too much of a ball ache to do it, which is a bit of a shit one if you ask me. But to be honest, given the last 3 years, it's not more than I expected. There are still Ramonas within the House of Commons, of course. But like I said a moment ago, don't worry about these Ramonas trying to interrupt the Brexit celebrations. Just ignore them and enjoy the night, because at the end of the day, they still lost. They're a bunch of losers, and that's all they'll ever be. No good Ramonin tosspots without a grip on reality. But on that note, I am going to end the video there. Before I go though, I am doing live streams and gaming content on my second channel when I get some spare time. So if you are interested in joining my live streams to chat with me in real time, have an interest in gaming content on YouTube, or just want to follow me over there because you're an absolute legend, the link is in the video description below and as a pinned comment. I hope to see you all there. Now, as always, I want to thank our YouTube, PayPal, Patreon, and Subscribestar members for supporting the channel, along with everyone who watches my videos. Remember to let me know what you guys think down in the comment section below. Leave a like, subscribe with the notification bell, and share this video as it helps the channel a lot. And I will see you all in the next one.
There is a pattern consistent throughout history of oppressed people turning on the oppressors. Slaves against their owners, the peasantry against the feudal barons, colonies, Mr. Verhofstadt, against their empires. And that is why Britain is leaving. And it doesn't matter which language you use, we are going and we are glad to be going. We're off.
Ramon! Ramon!